2004, the residential buy-to-let property market was booming. However, this favorable economic situation has changed dramatically in the years since then. Joining me in studio now to give us some insights into what the South African buy-to-let property market looks like at the moment and whether it could return to its former glory is John Lewis, property strategist at F&B. John, thanks so much for joining us today. Just to put it in perspective, I mean, 2004, the likes of buy-to-let property accounted for 24% of total property sales. We're looking at 7% now. Dramatic difference since then.
Yes, I think, Elenia, some of that in 2004 could be deemed to be speculative. People looking for, they were buy-to-let buyers, putting a tenant in, but they're looking for short-term capital growth. That isn't there anymore, so that group has fallen away by and large. And then also what's happened since is, with that huge price growth on property and not such huge rental growth at the time during the boom years, your yields shrunk and property gradually, or not so gradually, sort of rapidly became a less attractive investment for a buy-to-let buyer. At the moment, we're sitting with relatively low yields. We've had a relatively weak rental market for some time now. But there is a flicker of light at the end of the, what still is probably a lengthy tunnel, in that we're starting to see Stats SA's rental figures show rising rental inflation. We don't have comprehensive rental data in the country, but if that's more or less accurate, that's a good sign from a widening yield point of view, and ultimately somewhere another few years down the road, probably buy-to-let buying will be a very attractive option, but at the moment it is not an attractive option.
So John, 7% right now, as we say, total property sales, not a healthy figure, because it's basically been unchanged for the last 6 months.
Look, we don't know what it was before the boom either. I suspect it was a lot lower than 25% as well. But yes, it seems that 7%, my gut feel is it's a very low figure. Banks are relatively conservative on their lending criteria still, and the household sector is under significant financial pressure. So those buy-to-let investors are probably only the very seasoned ones, people who can still get good yields when they go and bargain on auctions and or bargain with buyers. But I think by and large, the less seasoned investor is very much out of the market at the moment.
Mm. Well, just looking at where property prices are going, because we've basically had a flat year, is what we could call, for the likes of 2010. Yes, we saw a little bit of an increase, but definitely not to the extent that we saw during the boom years in 2004, 5, or even 6. Just taking a look at the prospects going forward, if we don't see a substantial increase in property prices, then you were talking about short-term capital gains, and that's why investors would buy too late going forward as well. So tell us about how that scenario could play out in 2011.
Well, I think I don't expect any significant price growth in 2011. I think that the average price for this year will be very similar to last year's one. That would imply possibly a real price decline. The reason being that I don't see much of a stimulus this year. We're looking at flat interest rates now for the year. They are relatively low, but interest rate cuts are the big stimulus, not sideways movements in interest rates. And a very mediocre economy coupled to a very high level of household debt to disposable income still. So it's not a wonderful picture. The household sector isn't in financially great health, and a relatively flat market. For buy-to-let, though, that's perhaps what the doctor ordered, not for now, but for a few years' time. A couple of years of low price growth and a rental market that's, well, I anticipate some recovery in the rental market and stronger rental, improving rental inflation means that yields start to widen. And if they widen, you know, at some point it becomes attractive yet again, possibly not yet this year, but maybe next year or the year after, becomes attractive again from a yield point of view to actually buy to let. So that's a low price growth for the future buy-to-let investor is not necessarily a bad thing. Mm.
Well, it's quite interesting that you say that, because we hear some consumers saying, well, they don't think that the property market is going to go very far over the next couple of years, and because it's going to have a flat performance, they rather rent than purchase. So that will obviously also add more impetus to the buy-to-let market growing quite extensively if there is more demand for rental properties.
I think there's that, but I think more to the point is that it's tough for first-time buyers to buy a property, so a group of them would be staying in the rental market for longer, also driving demand. It's tough not only because of conservative bank criteria, relatively conservative, but job creation isn't what it was. Mm. So there aren't that many new entrants into the job market at the moment, compared to a few years ago, so therefore that keeps people relatively, I guess, pressured.
Well, it's quite interesting. I mean, the lower end of the market, I mean, the houses that are, you know, the flats that are between, say, 300,000 rand to 500,000 or even 600,000, that's where we're really starting to see quite a lot of demand coming through for actually buying that property. And then when you start reaching out of that band, things also change quite extensively. Do you think that, you mentioned now, I mean, household debt to income ratio is still relatively high. Do you think that the power of the consumer is still yet to be felt in South Africa? I mean, retail sales came in really strong for the month of November.
Concerns me, the retail sales figures. It's a good number and reflects the fact that we're out of recession at least, but
7.8% I think for the month of November.
Yes, but but I do get I am rather concerned about the fact that we are a consuming nation. The savings rate for the third quarter started to deteriorate again for the household sector. The debt to disposable income ratio started to rise again in the third quarter of last year. We need to become a savings nation. So one must be careful what you wish for. Retail sales look very nice at coming in at 7.something%, but there are a few structural issues to sort out which could hammer us in the longer term if we don't.
Okay, looking at the overall scenario that is playing out in South Africa, I mean, you mentioned that the interest rates are going to stay relatively flat for the rest of the year. We had a cut last year in November at 5.5% is what the repo rate is at the moment. And looking at the prospects for inflation, inflation figure that is still relatively benign, I mean, for December it came in at 3.5% from 3.6%, John. But are you concerned about perhaps the changing inflationary environment in South Africa going forward, which could mean more pressure on consumers, which will have less disposable income if this does happen?
Well, at the moment, the inflationary environment looks very good, but yes, I'm anticipating some gradual uptick throughout the year. Not problematic inflation, but we have seen oil prices climb, we have seen petrol price hikes, and one of the big components of CPI these days is rentals, residential rentals and owner-occupied rentals, and that inflation rate too starting, I anticipate, to rise. So I don't think troublesome inflation, but yes, when you do get rising inflation, and given that there's something of a lag normally from when inflation rises to when wages respond in some fashion, yes, I think gradually you could get more pressure on disposable, or inflation could eat into disposable income more, i.e. a slower real disposable income growth rate this year than what we had in the last few quarters.